Good morning students, welcome to challenge series. In this video I am going to solve a problem from the topic alternating currents. This problem I have considered from the IIT previous papers asked in 2019. Observe this question. Here one circuit is given to us. This circuit consists of one resistor, capacitor, one resistor and inductor, and one applied voltage is there. Here resistor, capacitor values, resistor, inductor values and applied voltage expression is given to us. What we need to find here means the current passing through this branch is I2 and the current passing through this branch is I1. The phase difference between these two currents is asked. Find the phase difference between I1 and I2. So first, if we consider how to solve this is, if you consider this loop, this is a RL circuit. Similarly, if we consider this loop, this is a RC circuit with some applied voltage. So we know the phase difference between RC. In RC circuits, what is the phase difference between current and voltage? We know. And in RL circuit, what is the phase difference between current and voltage? We know. But here in this question, we need to find the phase difference between I1 and I2. Let us see how to solve this. Here in RC circuit, generally the current leads voltage, whereas in RL circuit the current lags the voltage. Here in RC circuit, see R2 we have considered, corresponding current is I2, let us take it, and in RL circuit that is R1 given here and inductor L value, so that let us take this one is I1. What is leading, what is lagging? If we consider this voltage here, I2 leads the voltage. Leading means you should take upwards. Here the phase difference between I2 and V let us consider as Φ2, and I1 and V let us consider as Φ1. So here I2 leads V by Φ2 and I1 lags V by Φ1. For applied voltage, the current I1 lags by Φ1. Leading and lagging, how to identify means simply, in the clock, if you take right hand side, if you take two quantities, the upper quantity is the leading quantity, the lower quantity is the lagging quantity. Simply. Here in RC circuit, I leads V. That means I is upper. Next, in RL circuit, I lags V. That's why I1 is lower to V. We need to find the phase difference between I1 and I2. That means here, the phase difference, if you consider, Φ1 plus Φ2 is the phase difference we need to find. What is this Φ value we need to find now? For that, here I2 leads V in RC circuit. How much it leads means Φ2 value, the expression we know that is tan inverse XC by R. Similarly, in RL circuit, current lags voltage by the phase Phi is equal to tan inverse XL divided by R. This is C, this is L. So, in the given data, RC and RLs are given. So, we need to find XL and XC first from the given data, and then Φ1 and Φ2. Then we can add both the values to find the required phase difference. Let us do that. Here XC, let us calculate XC value, that is 1 by omega C, and XL value with the formula omega into L. Here what is omega? In the applied voltage expression, 200 root 2 sine 100 t is there. If you compare with the standard formula, this is omega sin omega t. So that omega value 100 and C value, if you observe, root 3 by 2 microfarad given. So for that, XC is equal to 1 divided by omega value 100 and C value root 3 by 2. 2 I am writing here. Microfarad here. That means here 10 to the power of minus 6. That means here 10 to the power of 2 is there. That means here minus 6. So minus 4. So we will get 2 into 10 to the power of 4 divided by root 3 is the xv value. Similarly, xl value omega into l. Omega value 100 and l value, it is given that root 3 by 10. So that it is 10 root 3. Xc value, xl value we obtained. Now phi 2 and phi 1 let us calculate. So phi 2 is tan inverse, xc value is 2 into 10 to the power of 4 divided by root 3, and r value is given here. Phi 2 means we need to consider r2, and for phi 1 in RL circuit this is r1, that's why let us take it as r1. So r2 value is given that 20. That means 2 10 times, here 10, this goes 10 to the power of 3, that means 1000 divided by root 3. Tan inverse 1000 divided by root 3, we got it. So this quantity is too large quantity. That means we can consider this one as a tan inverse infinity, that means 90 degrees is the phase difference phi 2. Similarly, phi 1 let us calculate. That is tan inverse, xl value we got 10 root 3 divided by r1. R1 is given that 10 ohms. So that tan inverse root 3, that is 60 degrees. So finally we got phi 2, phi 1, 90 degrees and 60 degrees. That means here phi value we need, phi 1 plus phi 2, 60 degrees plus 90 degrees, it is 150 degrees phase difference between these two quantities I1 and I2 in the given circuit. Thank you.